Oh, of course. I mean, you know, any type of gain that I can get from whether Sim starting slow or, you know, his defensive laps or whatever it is, I'm looking forward to capitalizing off of everything. You know, this is a sport where, you know, you don't want to wait till the last minute. You want to get it going. And I believe if I'm in the best shape and I can apply 100% each and every round, then I definitely see myself being victorious. No, I'm not one of those guys who gained 25 pounds and, you know, I'm a skinny guy too. So it's also good that I have Chris Algieri as my nutritionist to make sure that I can have the protein, the right amount of nutrition for my body to maximize each and every training session. And leading up to the fight, I'm pretty sure I'm going to make weight fairly easy.
He's a smart guy.
He really is. Smart guy. He knows his stuff. He knows boxing. He knows what it takes to have the mental strength, you know, to prevail. I think fighting in New York City in my hometown is just, it's icing on the cake. You know, I've been able to do a lot since coming back from cancer. Things that really surprised me and things that I thought I never could accomplish. And this is being the pinnacle. This is being the ultimate. You know, I never thought I would have my own pay-per-view in New York City headlining in Madison Square Garden. I just, you know, when I first came back, I just wanted to be inside the ring. You know, that made me happy. That in itself. So for me to accomplish all these different things, man, I just really feel like, you know, God has plans for me.
In a short space of time.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's truly remarkable.
You know, when
one of those fights where if you go throughout the history of boxing and you match up the best versus the best, majority of those fights were at Madison Square Garden. Majority of those fights, you know, were competitive. And to know that, you know, when I get older one day and I retire and I'm able to tell my grandkids about my career, I'll be able to tell them that I was a part of that legacy. I was a part of, you know, being the best versus the best. And, you know, I mean, I just get excited just thinking about it because, you know, I'm a big fan of the sport. I'm a big family man. And this is what I do it for. And I also do it for one day just looking back on all that I've done and say, man, you've done very well for your, you know, coming from Brownsville, Brooklyn, New York, where none of this stuff could be possible. You know, you've done fairly well for yourself.
I heard people come out of Brownsville.
It's been a lot of great fighters that come out of Brownsville. Mike Tyson, Riddick Bowe, you know, Shannon Briggs, list goes on and on, Zab Judah. So just to be added to that list alone, I'm grateful. However people want to place me, that's fine, but I'm just grateful, and I can never, in my opinion, surpass Iron Mike Tyson. He's just legendary. Legendary. I mean, people who walked through that building, who took those elevators up and was in the same locker room, you know, you don't really think about that stuff, but it's electrifying. You know, I'm grateful to be able to walk the same footsteps as those guys and perform under those same lights. Thank you.